This is a very brief conceptual exam problem. This problem basically deals with elementary reaction. A goes to B, so a simple isomerization reaction that can be conducted in one of three reactors, different types of PFR and CSTR reactors. And so we want to know in which case the consumption rate of A at the reactor outlet is lowest. In a CSTR, of course, the outlet conditions where we want to be able to determine that reaction rate are everywhere the same inside the reactor. And what we're trying to determine in the case of the PFRs is that sort of right before we exit the reactor, what's going to have the lowest reaction rate. So the reaction rate is going to be linearly related to concentration in this case because we have an elementary reaction that involves one A molecule on the reactant side and is irreversible. And so we can write that in terms of a first order dependence on the concentration because of the implied one stoichiometric coefficient in front of A. And so that means that the rate is going to be lowest when the concentration is lowest because K is fixed at a given temperature. The temperature we know is set because the reaction is conducted isothermally. All right, so the K is going to be fixed. And so wherever we have the lowest concentration at the outlet, and in other words, the highest conversion, we'll expect to have the lowest rate. The concentration, if we look at, for example, comparing the 40-liter PFR to the 100-liter PFR, so the reactors of the same type, all right, we're going to expect the concentration to be the concentration of A in the 100-liter PFR to be less than the concentration of A in the 40-liter PFR. That's because we basically have allowed more time to react. In the 100-liter PFR, we have a longer space time, a longer residence time, and so there's more time for A to be consumed, and so therefore the concentration will be lower. All right, and furthermore, we're going to expect the 100-liter PFR to be lower in concentration than an 80-liter CSTR. And that's because for a positive order reaction, a CSTR is less efficient than the same sized PFR. So even if we only had an 80-liter PFR, we would expect to achieve a higher conversion and therefore a lower outlet concentration than in the CSTR. We talked in previous screencasts about why this would be the case. It has to do with the fact that you can't achieve as much conversion in a CSTR because the reaction is all occurring at the final conditions, which are typically the lowest rate conditions when you have a positive order reaction. Right, and so therefore we're able to achieve a lower concentration of A inside the 100-liter PFR than either of the other reactors. And so this is going to be the lowest value. And therefore, the reaction rate will have the lowest value for a 100-liter PFR.